Hello, everyone. Today, we will install the ATX board for Comet in just 4 simple steps. Subscribe now for more video guides. For clarity, the controlling device will be referred to as Device A, and the device being controlled as Device B. The ATX board is an optional but powerful accessory for your GL.iNet KVM setup. This smart module lets you control your Device B's power supply remotely, just like pressing the physical power button. It's perfect for stable power management. Inside the box, you will find the ATX board, USB-A to C cable, 9-pin wire set, mounting screws, and 2 bracket sets. Please have a screwdriver ready as well. First, pick the ATX bracket that fits your computer. Then, secure the ATX board to the bracket set using the mounting screws. Power off your computer completely and open the case to access the interior. Essentially, we are using the 9-pin wire set connecting the ATX board to the Device B, where Interface 4 is connected to Device B's control line and Interface 5 to its front panel connectors. The interface polarity may vary depending on different PC chassis. Please double-check it before installation. This video will show you 10-to-1 panel and 20-to-5 panel configurations. So now, locate the control line and front panel connectors on Device B. There should already be wires connected to the panel. Carefully remove those existing wires from the motherboard. For 10-to-1 pin panel, use the 9-pin wire set provided in the package. Referring to this diagram, connect one end to the Interface 4 of ATX board and the other end to the Device B's front panel. Make sure the watermarks on the 9-pin wire set are facing outward. Next, use the wires that were originally from Device B. Connect them to Interface 5 of the ATX board. There may be cases where you cannot turn Device B on or off via the GLKVM control page. If this happens, return to this step and try flipping the connector polarity. The final result should look like this. For 20-to-5 pin panel, the steps are similar to before, where we are using the 9-pin wire set provided in the package. The only difference is that we refer to this diagram. Connect one end to the Interface 4 of ATX board and the other end to the Device B's front panel. Make sure the watermarks on the 9-pin wire set are facing outward. Similarly, there may be cases where you cannot turn Device B on or off via the GLKVM control page. If this happens, return to this step and try flipping the connector polarity. The final result should look like this. Finally, place the ATX board bracket on the side frame of the computer chassis. Connect the Comet and ATX board using the USB-A to C cable. That's it. You have successfully set up the ATX board for the first time. Now, in the GLKVM interface, under the Accessories tab, you will be able to power on and off or reboot your computer remotely. Remember to subscribe to us for more videos like this.